Hi, welcome back to Code to Start with Mohammed Fathi. This is our YouTube channel. We are still talking about the Dart Aqueduct framework. So let me first create a new project by go to your working directory. Here I am gonna open, for example, you can open your terminal. And here I am gonna open the CMD on Windows, and this is a CMD will be inside the Dart server. So here I am gonna use the Aqueduct command, create lesson 3 and press enter. So after this project created, I am gonna go to inside this folder by typing cd lesson 3 and press enter and open this with my editor. Here I'm gonna open it with the VS Code. You can open it in Android Studio, in IntelliJ, any editor. You can open it by your favorite editor. So let me open this by the VS Code by typing code dot and press enter. That project will be opened in VS Code. So each project will consist of controller. So the controller will compose a channel. So a channel is a group of controller. So let me open the lib here. The lib here will be the your project code will live here inside this lib folder or library folder. So let me open the lesson 3. So the lesson 3 is the file will import this will export the Dart async and the Dart IO, a group of library. It will be exported as one using the lesson 3.dart, and the important one is the channel.dart. Here the our application channel will be here. So the application channel is an object that contains all of the controllers in an application. It designates one controller as the first controller to receive every request called its entry point. So this will contain all the controller, and it contain the controller called the router. So this router will receive any request. So let me first remove this all of this comments here to make it smaller. And remove this. Yes, you can remove all of this. Okay, so this is a controller. You can understand the channel as this. This is the application channel. It will contains a controller. This is the first controller. It's called the router controller, and another controller called hero controller. And it can be contains more than one controller. So first, our project not contains only contain the router controller. This is will receive the incoming HTTP request. So let me make another one here. So this will be the router controller will be receive another path. So this is called the path. So let me make another bus here, router dot route. So this route, this is a pattern will be, for example, courses. And it, I am gonna here link this path with this callback function. So this is a request, and here I am gonna make a response. So here this will be response dot okay. So a query response with, for example, all courses. So you can make, for example, here you can make a response with this object, and here the key with the data and the value, a list of objects. You can make this list as final here. Let me make this list underscore courses equal here the first one where the ID will be 1, the name will be for example Dart programming, and make another one here. This is a let me Flutter or PHP, and the ID will be number 2. So another course create by duplicate this. So this is will be the Flutter mobile, and the ID will be 3. The last one, let me create this. So this is a number 4, and this is will be, let me this will be asp.net. So now I can response with this underscore courses. So let me open this by first open the terminal here, terminal, and here I'm gonna type aqueduct serve. So this is will be open the server and execute the main and open the server listening to incoming request on using this port. So let me open this by go here and typing local host this port, and here the path will be courses, and to press enter now the all courses are here. So this is a simple route or a simple path with a link function. So let me, instead of writing the logic here, we can create a controller. But before creating this, we can make the logic. You can, for example, let me create the controller. Here I am gonna create the controller. So inside the left folder, I am gonna create a file called courses controller inside the folder called controller. So I'm gonna make a folder called controller. Inside this folder, I'm gonna create a courses underscore controller or course underscore controller dot dart. So inside this, I'm gonna create a class. So this class called course controller. This will be extended the controller class, controller or resource controller. Here I'm gonna extend the controller, and here I'm gonna override missing here, create a missing override. So this missing override is the method called handle that will return future or request or response. So the future or here means this method can return future of request or response, or it can be return request or response without the future. So and this method called the handle, and it will receive the request at the parameter. So let me here, I can here, for example, make a switch here. First, you can make switch on the request dot method. So here, I'm gonna make a case. So case it is a get method. So get HTTP method. So if it's HTTP get method, I'm gonna return response. dot ok, and here I'm gonna return get method else and break here, sorry, break, and make another default here. I'm gonna return response dot ok and not get. So after that I'm gonna use the postman or any HTTP other than the browser. So let me break here, and here instead of this I'm gonna copy this and make a comment here. So instead of this I'm gonna link a function here. I'm gonna use a link, so let me remove this. And here I am gonna dot link. So dot link will link to a controller. So it will be best practice to separate. Instead of writing the logic here, I am gonna put the logic inside the controller. So this will return a new instance of the course controller. See here I am gonna return new instance of the course controller. So we need now to restart the server by typing Control C to close and yes to OK and open the Aqueduct server again. So the server now is running. You can go here and when you so the get the message is get. So now we are using the browser. So in the future I'm gonna use the or in the next lecture we will use the postman. So if you open the postman here, typing postman, so when you make this, let me copy this and let me try to this is a request here. I'm gonna Control V, paste the request here and send. So I am so sorry. Let me copy this again. Okay, and try to post here and click send. Now let me make this get and click send. Now the get method and the response is 200. Okay, so if you change this from get to post, for example, and click send, now it's not a get. So you can make, for example, this, you can make a switch here to for example, let me copy this and here make post. So post and also here the post the put to update. So here put and the last one will be the delete. So here delete. So and else is not defined. You can make here not or undefined. So let me restart by Control C, yes, and open the Aqueduct serve again. So now if you make this and click on the get and send, now get method, if you change this to post and click the post method and put the put method and the delete. So delete, so delete is I think delete is delete, yes, it's not completed. So let me now, you can start Control C and open this again by yes, when you click delete and send, now it will be the delete method. If you choose anything, for example, anything and click, it will be undefined. So now let me when it's get method, I am gonna return. So let me cut this from here and I'm gonna put it here. Let me save and put it here inside this controller. So and here I'm gonna return okay with the underscore courses. So try to save and control C, yes, and open the server again. And when you make the here the get, so get and press send. Now the response, it will, yes, let me start the server. Why this is error underscore courses. This package, try to open the server. Yes, server now is working. No, something error here. Application failed to restart and code error. Invalid controller curse controller must have a setter for the field must mark at the final. So here let me, this is error. Let me mark this final. And here I'm gonna start the server. So now it's working. It's working, the server now it's working. When I hear get and press, so it will return the courses. So now the channel, if you go here, the this is a channel. So the channel consists of the this router. It's a controller. This is what responsible for the entry point. It will take the request, and if it's this request matches this pattern, it will execute this function. If this request matches this, it will gonna pass the a request to this controller. So now the you can think of the channel. So this is a channel will contain the two controller. The first one is the router controller, and the second one is the course controller. So let me open this. So this is a channel here. It will contain the first controller is the router controller, and the second controller is the course controller. So the channel, a composition of controllers is called a channel because the requested follow in one direction through the controller. So the requested by go in one direction through this controller. If the controller for example, you can use a controller to authorized or validate the authorized. This is called a middleware. When you implement or make your code or your business code, this is called the endpoint controller. So the controller can be this is a controller. Any controller, it can be a middleware. So the middleware, like it will not use, it will not write your own code inside the middleware. It's a reusable controller. You can use it in any channel or any controller. This is called the middleware. So let me write here. There are two types of controller, the middleware controller. Controller. This is, you can think of this as a reusable controller. And you will not implement Yes, a logic inside this controller. This controller, it's like a built-in controller. This is called the middleware controller. The another type is called the endpoint controller. Point controller. This will contains your code or business logic. Logic and it will make response. So this is a endpoint, and it will make a response like the here, like this controller, the course controller. So now this controller will make a response here. You can use in upcoming lecture. I am gonna use the authorized controller. So the authorized controller will be verify the authentication of the user. This is called the middleware controller. So please don't forget to share my video, leave a comment, and see you in the next.